Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, welcome back to American Truck Simulator with me, cwattyeso, and we're about to join Seymour Butts as he takes a contract to deliver a forwarder from Gallup, New Mexico, all the way to San Diego, California, which is going to take us through a couple of new cities, Camp Verde, Flagstaff. It's also going to take us through Yuma, El Centro, and finally into San Diego. And it's going to make us $43,000, which should take our money nicely up to just over $200,000, at which point I'm going to buy my own truck. And then we're going to start doing some proper trucking jobs using our own truck, driving to the destination, picking up the trailers, and of course,
we've got a trek ahead of us. Stay safe, my friend.
I've also just installed a brand new mod for me that I've never used before. As you can see, it puts all the information stuff and the sat nav in the middle of the screen at the bottom. So rather than having that great big blocky thing over on the right hand side of the screen,
in 0.1 miles, turn right.
Neater. And also, if I turn off the thing, I could turn off the sat nav completely and just use the one that's on the vehicle dashboard. But then I still have access to all the other information. So, like my speed, what gear I'm in, how much fuel I've got, whether I'm going to be delivering on time and what have you. My speed, I can still keep a tab on that. But it just makes the screen slightly less cluttered.
In 0.1 miles, turn left.
Which is going to be useful when I have my own truck, because then you'll be able to see more of my own truck's
turn
dashboard.
Left.
Animals, or anything likely to come down here? But there we go. We will sort this out.
In 0.1 miles, turn left.
0.1 miles, turn left. So
turn left.
Okay, we are turning left here. Okay, because those X's tell us we can't go that way. But yeah, we're starting to branch out a bit. This is going to be one of the longest jobs I've probably done in terms of actual total distance. And then we're going to be looking at maybe getting our own truck, like I say. And obviously it gives me a chance to drive a Kenworth, lovely Kenworth, which could be my first truck purchase, because we do have access, of course, to a Kenworth dealer. In fact, actually, we've got access to all the dealers.
In 0.1 miles, turn left.
Better call Saul. Right, so we're going to go left a bit here.
Turn left.
And then turn right in a minute, which is going to take us on towards Flagstaff.
Keep right and then turn right.
Now
turn right.
Are we allowed to turn right on red? Biden's nothing's coming, we should be allowed to turn right on red. There we go. No penalties. It's going to be nice for Seymour to have his own truck. We've worked up to it. We've done a lot of these quick jobs. It's going to be nice to be able to take our own truck. It should help us make more money, which then means we should be able to get other trucks and add other trucks to our fleet, our garage, which will then enable us to hire some drivers to drive for us, which means that we'll then be moving into less of the solo management career stuff, and we'll be operating more actually as a company then, because we'll have employees to manage. We'll then be looking at maybe getting trailers, doing some, having our own trailers, which again should help us to charge more money for delivering, because we're providing all our own equipment, which means we could charge a premium price then to the companies to ship their goods for them. Obviously going to try and keep my eye on some of these cars before, because some of these AI cars have a tendency to drive into you. Although I should now be using at least a mod that should maybe make them a little, tries to make them a little bit smarter, and also tries to make the speed and the density a little bit better. We can bypass the way station. Okay. Guy. Huh. Wow. The Kenworth has just raised its game a little bit for me. In that the brakes on the Kenworth are incredible. Cause I was expecting to plow straight through the back of that car. I honestly was, yet somehow we managed to stop. But that was close.
Continue straight.
We also need to make sure on whatever truck we eventually get, we get one which has a massive air horn, so we can really give drivers like that a good blasting. Because that was just insane what that guy did to me then. He's in the wrong lane and he just pulls across. He realises that he's going into the weigh station. He doesn't need to be in there because he's a car. Doesn't check his mirrors, doesn't indicate, just pulls across directly into my path as I'm speeding along at 75 miles an hour. Disgusting driving there.
Continue straight.
I am doing, Liam. Oh, coming up on the outside of me, so I'll make sure I keep to the, I said keep left and then the road bent. But once we get me our own truck, I'm gonna be taking a bit of time to obviously get the seat position adjusted, get the mirrors adjusted to how I kind of want them.
Keep right.
I haven't bothered with any of that stuff.
Exit right.
Whilst we've been driving the rented vehicles, the
exit
loan vehicles.
Right. In 0.1 miles, turn left. Turn left.
I'm slightly oversized. Gotta watch that. Big loader on the back. We do not need to be smashing the van into the middle of the intersection. So give him a little bit of chip time to move. I'm also going to swing this round. Oh yeah, turn like a pro. Back into the sat nav cab, so we rely a little bit more on the in cab sat nav.
Police reported ahead.
Oh well, Mr. Liam, you're gonna have to do something about that, Mr. Liam, because you're taking us all through these cities again, Liam, instead of just taking me onto the single highway, the most straightforward direction. You're making me go through all the towns and having to deal with all these silly little intersections and traffic lights. Quite possibly in the wrong lane, because obviously some of these cars are wanting to turn right and probably can't, and they're blocking the junction. Some of them want to go straight on. but are waiting for the light. There could be then cars that want to turn right but can't because they're blocked by the car in front that wants to be straight on. Whereas if I was in the right-hand lane, I'd just be able to go when the lights go green. Chances are we're not going to get through the lights on this occasion.
Continue straight.
I'm going to have to stop. That was a bit of a bugger. Yeah, when you're going through the towns and cities, I really must try and remember to get over into the right-hand lane. Then we're not going to be slowed down by vehicles faffing about turning or wanting to turn. Obviously this truck is a little faster.
Continue straight.
What's that guy doing? Well, I'm going to move over now.
Continue straight.
I'm going to be in the good lane. Come on, truck. It's the car you got to watch out for, because at a certain point it'll disappear from view below the bonnet and I won't know it's there, and I'll end up driving into it because I'll forget basically that there is a car in front of me. And it doesn't help when you brake test me like that on the railway line. That's terrible from the car as well to do that to me. Do not slow down on trade traction, you muppet. There we go. Nice and driving again. Ooh, I think I hit the barrier there, but I don't think I caused any damage. Don't think my money changed, so you may have just scraped it. May have just done a bit of a paint remodeling on the side of the truck. Okay, this guy's gonna car's pulled out to overtake the truck, which is part of the AI mod that I installed last night after talking with Helgi. There's that mod and obviously the one that changes and puts the information bar at the bottom of the screen. Those were two mods that he told me about and discussed with me on Discord last night, so I figured, hey, I'll add them. And it works quite well. The little information bar definitely helps. It's nice not to have that great big block of stuff on the side of the screen. And if you've got built-in sat-nav, even better. This is going to be Saturday morning, 2 a.m. delivery apparently, so we're going to be driving through the night time. What a long ass journey this is going to be. But then we're going to be breaking into, like you say, California. Then we're going to, we'll have reached down the second state and start to have a few more cities unlocked. Take this lorry, unfortunately, because it's only a single carriageway at this point in time. We're turning left anyway, right in a minute anyway.
In 0.1 miles, turn right. Turn right.
Okay, so this guy is not turning right. He's going straight. Otherwise, he could have turned. Starting to get a bit busy. Oh, he is turning right. That's interesting. I wonder if he can do it on red. I'm going to stay in the right hand lane. Because I may get an opportunity to overtake him. At the traffic lights. Okay, I didn't get fined for that. A little bit maybe late going through the yellow. This bus is kind of worrying me a bit.
Police reported ahead.
You kind of forget to look, check your speed. Come on, bus. You're gonna race me. This is freaking me out.
Continue straight.
Put the brakes on. I'm not risking it. No fines on this journey. Not any fines, any tickets. Because this is going to pull us over 200 grand, which should definitely buy us a good truck. A good first starting truck. Again, I've not had a look so far at what's available to me from the different dealers, the different brands. I haven't had a chance to look and see what messages I've had from people to say, what comments I've had from people to say, you know, this is the truck you should get. This would make a good, you know, this would make a good starting truck. Would be useful for the type of deliveries you tend to make. Do not muck about. See the controller. My controller's mucking about a bit. Since I've put my PC, disconnected all my PC and redid my, put a brand new office desk in my room here, in my office, and reset everything up. I noticed it last night when I was playing Farm Sim. That for some reason every now and then my controller will just, the right analog stick just jumps about, which is really annoying when that controls the camera. It's a pain in the backside for Farm Sim because the only way to move the camera is with the right analog stick. At least with this I can use the circle button on the controller to switch to the in-cab view, or I can go external with the up button on the D-pad. Put the cruise control on. I believe it's set at 62 or 63 or whatever. Well, the cruise control's doing a bad job of keeping me at the speed I set. I think downhill, it doesn't apply brakes downhill, does it? The cruise control. Now we're going ever so slightly uphill. So now you can hear the engine kicking. Now the cruise control's working. I wonder if that's why you need the retarder thing. To reduce speed on the downhill slopes and keep it at its cruise value. Sudden change of speed limit there, from 65 down to 45. Caught me slightly unawares. Now it's going to go down to 35. This is a bit of a windy road. What a view though, eh? What a view. Gas station now. If we needed to refuel, this is going to be tight. Can I do a special cargo job on this road, because it does feel a little bit familiar, being all twisting and bendy like this. Definitely feels like I came down here on one of those escort roads. Traffic coming, I'll take advantage of that. Give myself plenty of room. And turn. Close to the barrier there. Yeah, I've definitely been on this road before. I know I have. San Carlos, Apache Indian Reservation. You've got the Terry Crews, Old Spice advert there, look. Smell power! Terry Crews, yeah. Tonto National Forest. Not a little bit. That sound to me sounds a little bit racist, calling that Tonto Forest. Calling Indians Tonto, that just seems a little bit disrespectful. Right, we're now at 55 mile an hour speed limit territory, so the windy bit's probably finished at this point. So we're going to be turning left up ahead.
Keep left, and then turn left. Turn left.
Yes, we are open, apparently. Stay in the right-hand lane. Oh, no, we'll move into the left lane.
Keep right.
We are turning
and
left.
Then turn right.
Sorry, turning right.
Turn right.
Just going to be down this bit of road here, so start fairly wide. Go left through. Tucson. Arizona. A bit of a bendy, windy road. Let's have a quick look on the map then. So we've been down sort of here. Right, so we're going to go through Tucson. Do we really want to go through Tucson? We don't really want to be going into Tucson. We've kind of messed up here, actually. It's coming down this road. We could have actually gone through Phoenix. I don't know why that was taking me in there to mess with those.
Are you prepared? Only the certain will make it. Let's move forward.
Yeah, I probably messed up the sat nav. I've probably been using the wrong sat nav. That's probably took me the wrong way. Still got 7 hours of driving ahead of us. We are delivering slightly earlier now though, 5 to 2. So we have made a little bit of time up on our estimated delivery. Maybe that's because though I've saved traveling all the way through Tucson. Driving around there for no reason whatsoever. Unless I was doing it to try and discover those undiscoverables. I can't really afford that sort of thing. Hello, you've broke down. You've overheated your car.
Police reported ahead.
Let's just knock it back a touch then. No going left. Welcome to Tucson.
Police reported ahead.
Let's slow down a bit more.
Keep right, and then turn right. Turn right.
I'm assuming this guy isn't going to turn right then. Or he's been very lackadaisical about doing it. He had a chance to if he was going right, but it looks like he's going straight to me. Because he's not indicating. Hello, tractor. Incredibly tight that was for me to get around there with that lorry part there.
In 0.1 miles, turn right. Turn right.
Thing is, I won't have to pull any oversized cargo, really. You put my headlights on. Because it's starting to get dark. Once I've got my own truck, I'll hopefully be able to make money pulling normal cargo without necessarily the need to pull oversized stuff like this. I can make enough money from delivering normal goods. Looks like these two have had a bit of a bump, so I'm going to try and drive around them. I think the lorry and the cement truck have had a crash. Previously, last time I checked, going to be delivering just before 2 a.m. We're now delivering closer to 3 a.m. We've lost quite a bit of time there going through Tucson. And I don't think I'm going to be making that up anytime soon. San Diego, 2 miles. Nice. I've got a feeling it's more miles. Arizona City, 1 mile. We need to be keep in left, the middle lane.
And then keep right.
We're not going that way.
Keep right. And then exit right.
No, we're going this one.
Exit right.
No, we're not exiting. Most definitely not. We're not allowed to. Boss. Sorry, Liam. We're not allowed to exit. So that's going to put me on a different track now, so I'm not going to, where was we going through? We was going to go through, oh, it's going to take us, actually, it's going to take us into Phoenix. I wonder, there's a discoverable in Phoenix. I wonder if we can move that. In fact, there's a couple. That one over there. Gonna be that one there. Then we're gonna come through here, aren't we? I wanna grab that one while I'm there. El Centro doesn't have anything. I'll tell you who does. This place. So we'll get that one. And hopefully that one.
I urge you to relax at once. Now, enjoy the ride.
I'm going to give that a go. I'm going to see if I can hit all those different places. It's going to extend the time of the journey considerably. We're now looking up 4 hours for delivery. 4 a.m. for delivery. But hey, if I can tick off a few locations, then to me, that's all good.
Police reported ahead.
It looks like we're going to be taking the exit coming up now to go on a bit of a detour.
Continue straight. Keep left. Police reported ahead. keep right, and then exit right.
Excellent stuff. You did very well there, Liam. Hopefully this discoverable is going to be worth it. It's probably just going to be a,
keep right.
Couple of recruitment and agencies, maybe the possibility of a new garage.
Exit right.
I don't want to do that. No, because I've not been... Unless this is going to take me off and up to where I need to be.
Turn left.
Yeah, I'm going to swing out a bit more this way this time. I stacked the trailer last time.
Turn left.
And swing out nice and wide. Seymour's having trouble. This is turning into one heck of a long ass job. These cars gonna go? Because these cars just gonna keep coming at us. Well, it looks like there's plenty of room after this one. Oh, we all made it. If we're still on this road, we'll end up in Los Angeles. I don't think I really need to go quite that high up the map. Left, and then I'm going to go into the city, discover the discoverables.
Keep right, and then exit right.
Then I'll be back on this road
exit
going south.
Right. Turn left.
Again, I've overcooked that. Expecting the speed to drop off a little more. to swing out quite as wide for these sort of things. Right, so we're going to go along the road. I'm going to turn up.
Continue straight.
Reach Slow Town now.
In 0.1 miles, turn right.
Turn wrong, Liam says.
Turn right.
Good thing is I get to swing out really wide for this one. That front post, that stop sign is still kind of in the way of it. We shouldn't be coming through here with this, really, but... gives us a chance, doesn't it? To unlock a few things on a long-ass journey.
In 0.1 miles, turn right. Turn right.
Hit with dealership.
Continue straight.
So we found
in 0.1 miles, turn right. Turn right.
Right, and it must be a recruitment agency down here then, I would think. Driver staffing agency, it is indeed. Perfect.
In 0.1 miles, turn left. Turn left.
Got through there okay? Turn right.
In 0.1 miles, turn right.
We'll be back on the freeway.
Turn right.
There we go. Give it the full beans down here. Back on course, back on track, heading to wherever it is next. Through Yuma, quick find a discoverable, and then finally into San Diego. A couple of discoverables in there, and then we'll be on our way. think we're doing alright for fuel. We might be close.
Continue straight.
There it is, the fuel gauge is just over on the right hand side there. We're getting close to being on the red. I might put my full beams on now so I can see where I'm going at night. A lot quieter on the road now.
Police reported ahead.
We're now into the nighttime hours, so there should be some reduced traffic if the mod that we added last night to the game is working. Alright, we're back on these horrible bendy roads now then. Not a big fan of these, typically. But we've managed it. Seymour's getting there. Seymour's slightly managing journey. We've only had a couple of little scrapes so far.
In 0.1 miles, turn right.
Nothing that's going to ultimately crush into our profits, providing we obviously
turn right.
Pay attention to what we're doing. We do 75 down here, apparently. Gotta get up to speed quick. Fuel gauge is looking not healthy, but I'll be... You think I'm gonna pay for fuel for this truck? You must be having a laugh. Let's just have a quick look. If I was thinking of stopping for fuel anywhere, where would it likely to be? I mean, I could grab some down here. Could grab some back in here. See. That's because I've been gallivanting all over the shop. Hasn't it? There's a rest area 1 mile, but is there a fuel station in 1 mile? Looks to me to just be a rest area. Doesn't look like. Fuel there. There's a rest area on the other side of the road for people travelling south. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna dive off here. I'm gonna grab some fuel. I wouldn't normally, because obviously this is a quick job. It's not my truck, but because I've been driving everywhere.
In 0.1 miles, turn left. Turn left, and then turn right. Turn right.
Bit of fuel in, I'm not putting in loads. Well, that was very silly of you. Drive into me like that. Ending in disaster now. Stupid bus. Get out of my bus. Trailers took more damage. Good lord. Come on. Stupid lorry. More of them coming there. How am I going to do this? Smashed up the trailer a bit, but hey, it's got us where we need it to be. Got us some fuel. Detour over. This trip's costing me money now. I'm not a big fan of that. I'm not a big fan of having to pay money. Oh, there's a bit of a diversion ahead. Road works ahead. Okay. For humour, there's nothing in humour to interest us.
Keep right.
Ooh, the walls actually, it's a little discoverable. Exit right. There is a discoverable, so we're going to need to get that.
Exit right. Turn left.
Am I allowed to turn left on red? Is that a big no-no?
Keep left, and then turn
left.
I'll have
to turn right there.
Turn left. Make a U-turn.
There we go. We've got a demolition job though. This has been a bit of a demolition job, I'll be honest. This has not
in
been
0.1 miles.
A finest
turn
example
right.
of my driving talents and skills. I should have
turn
really
right.
just focused on doing the job. And not worried too much about picking up locations and stuff, but
keep left and then turn left.
Any left?
Turn left.
Pay me a great deal. Boom. Right, let's focus now. We've got a couple of little distractions still to go, but hopefully. Nothing too serious. They should be a little bit more easy and straightforward, the last two, because I'm not going to have to turn the vehicle, turn the trailer around like I did with the fuel and that Peterbilt dealerships. Although to be fair, dealerships in ATS aren't really as important as they are in Euro Truck, because there's not that many dealers. There's not that many available dealers, so stay in the truck lane. I'm not going to go any faster than this. To be fair, it would be nice if they actually went a little bit faster. These two. And Centro discovered.
Continue straight.
Didn't think there was anything really in El Centro to worry about, was there? steaming up on this guy. This is not good. These two guys are driving way too slow. I'm gonna try and floor it past them now.
Police reported ahead.
Okay, Liam. But I want to get past these trucks. Well, to be fair,
police
the guy
reported
dragging
ahead.
The hay bales is going to be a bit annoying. I got slowed down just in time. I saw that guy hiding. Could you stop brake testing me? Just flipping gun, a pair of you. Oh, this is not good. For me, I'm in the wrong lane. Surely. Trailer damage. Wrong side of the bendy road. Anybody coming inside me now is going to get flattened.
Police reported ahead.
Official police reported ahead, bollocks.
I just need to get to where I'm going. Right, I'm going to cut in here.
Police reported ahead.
I'm inside Mr. Bale trailer. Do on Mr. Bale trailer. Come on, get out of the road. I hate this when they're so close to you. I'm going this time. This time I'm not looking about. I could probably turn my full beacon beams off now. Just does seem to be a lot of trucks though in this area, all driving very slowly. Guy's coming. He's having a run at me again now. Struggle with my load up the hill. I'll be quick, quite honest, Carl. I really do not need you to be outside me there. And you best not be turning me.
Police reported ahead. Police reported ahead.
I've got to go in here. straight on.
Keep left.
To Tijuana. Aren't we? No, starting to rain. Going to the...
Keep right, and then exit right.
Oh! Flipping Nora. All the indicators on.
Exit right.
And the guy goes steaming into me.
Turn right.
This has been quite costly, this trip, in terms of fines so far. We've picked up a few. Had to pay for fuel as well, which is not good. Seriously, dude, move into the middle. That guy thought he was driving a tank or something, but he took that corner very wide in that blue car, didn't he? Thought for me he was going to drive into me.
In 0.1 miles, turn right. Turn right.
Oh. Smacked another vehicle. Another Peterbilt dealership.
In 0.1 miles, turn left.
Peterbilt's costing me a lot of money.
Turn left. Continue straight.
we go again. Another discoverable, which is going to be a recruitment agency, direct hire.
In 0.1 miles, turn right. Turn right.
Turn left again.
In 0.1 miles, turn left. Turn left. Reached your destination.
Where do you want it parking, mate? Stuck on. This is just going to go completely terrible. How do I make this thing go where I want it to go? Think about this. Not spinning like that one. I don't want it to spin that way. That's the way I want it to go. Suppose I've got to get straightened up. Basically, I've gone full on rip across the road. I face this way a bit more. Oh, I hate it when they make me park these oversized deliveries. Got to level 12 though. I'm going to take a point in fuel economy at this point. Whew. What a job for Seymour Butts that was. And that's brought us up to 209,000. So I'm definitely going to be buying a new truck at the start of the next video. So thank you everyone for watching this episode. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you put up with my incredible long ass journey all over the map. And I'll see you all again for another episode very soon. Goodbye for now.